Arts. So, ladies and gentlemen of the press corps, please welcome OIC Chair Ronald Cardema of the National Youth Commission.
Thank you, Secretary Roque. Good morning to the Malacanang Press Corps. Thank you for accommodating me here today. First, I'd like to give you some updates on the National Youth Commission, then specifically on the Sanggadiang Kabataan elections.
Tinicals, CNN Philippines.
Hi, sir. Sir, you mentioned earlier na 79,000 pa lang yung nag-file, yes, and 300K positions yung kailangan. Why do you think lesser youth want to get involved in government? Jaded ba sila na, you know, dahil corruption and everything that's going on?
Actually, I think that it's not because of corruption, because the president is trying to curb corruption. Sa tingin ko po, because ngayon lang uli talaga binalik ang SK. So, matagal na panahon na wala sa utak ng kabataan yung SK. Biglang binalik ngayon. And kalimitan naman sa mga Pilipino, alam nyo naman, minsan late talaga mag-file. And minsan, meron pang factor na sa barangay nyo, nagpapakiramdaman kayo kung sino magpa-file for SK chairman, SK kagawad, kasi ayaw nyo mag-away kayo. So, minsan up to the last day, nagpapakiramdaman. Alam nyo, iba kasi yung barangay SK sa ibang municipal or national elections. Kasi doon, di mo naman talaga nakikita yung kalaban mo lagi eh. Pero in the barangay, in the SK, mga kapitbahay mo lang yung kalaban mo pag nag-file kayo eh. Magkakakilala kayo. So, minsan ayaw nyo magkalaban kayo. You're waiting until the last day kung nag-file ba yung isa para ikaw mag-file naman. Pero sana mag-file na kayo. Kumbaga, it's a part of healthy democracy naman talaga to join the elections. And we need elected youth leaders na talaga right now so that mabago natin ang inyong mga barangay po. Ang binu-view po natin parang Singapore, South Korea. Very nationalistic yung mga kabataan nila, disciplined, prepared for disaster. Sana ganun tayo. Singapore has 8 million population. South Korea, 50 million. Tayo, 100 million population. So we have a big human resource and we just need to lead the youth towards nation building po.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hi, good morning, sir. Sir, may pinapatanong lang po yung taga Daily Manila Shimbun. Ano po yung role ng National Youth Commission sa drug war po ng administrasyon, considering na ilan sa mga nasawi sa drug war ay mga minor de edad? Ano po yung paninindigan ng NYC doon?
Ang paninindigan po ng NYC dyan, ma'am, is the youth mas participate talaga in eradicating drugs. Kumbaga, in other countries like Singapore, South Korea, active ang kanilang kabataan in support of nation building projects, of government projects. So sana sa ating kabataan dito sa Pilipinas, alam natin, for example, sa barangay, kilala naman natin kung sino mga drug addicts dyan. So sa information drive ng gobyerno, sana tumutulong tayo ipahatid sa ating barangay, sa ating mga kapwa kabataan, ang kasamaan ng droga. So sana po, tulungan natin ang ating gobyerno, tulungan natin ang Pangulo, tulungan natin ang ating mga government enforcers na dito sa kanilang anti-drug advocacy, anti-crime advocacy po. Kasi if we don't secure our barangay, mahirapan po i-secure your entire nation. The President needs the Filipino youth to lead their barangays, to lead their communities, para kapag nabago nyo inyong barangay, ang inyong community, kaya natin baguhin lahat ng ating bansa po. Thank you, ma'am.
AC Nicole.
The National Youth Commission under the Office of the President is the highest policy-making body for all youth programs, youth activities, and youth organizations in the country. And as such, we are currently supervising the return of the Sanggunian Kabataan with the DILG and COMELEC. We will look up to our neighbors like Singapore, South Korea, China, and Japan, because they are training their youth to become nation builders, to become patriotic citizens, and enjoining them to become military reservists so that when typhoons, earthquakes, tsunamis, and national emergencies besiege their society, they immediately deploy their youthful citizens to rescue their elderly and their families. Looking up to what our neighbors are doing, we fully support the desired policy of President Rodrigo Roa Duterte for the return of the mandatory ROTC for college students, mandatory CAT for high school students, and also to make scouting, Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts, mandatory for elementary students. With this desired policy of President Duterte, to return this reformed mandatory ROTC and military reservist training for the Filipino youth, we will be able to spread and inculcate nationalism faster and prepare an entire youthful generation of this country towards nation building. Another reformed youth program that the Duterte administration is returning this year is the Sangguniang Kabataan, or SK. With this national youth activity, we will be having around 350,000 elected youth leaders spread throughout the 42,000 barangays of the country. With the reformed SK, SK officials must undergo the required SK mandatory training. If they will not undergo the training, they cannot assume the position. So I am in front of you today because the National Youth Commission is reminding the Filipino youth to go out and participate in the Sangguniang Kabataan elections in your community. The filing of your SK Certificate of Candidacies is until April 20 only, meaning you have until Friday only to file your candidacy. We have one SK chairman position and seven SK kagawad positions for you in your barangay. Go out now. Go to your local COMELEC office and file your candidacy. President Duterte is doing his reforms, securing and uplifting our country for our youthful generation, for us to have a better and stronger country. Let the 350,000 incoming SK youth leaders in our country be the direct partners of President Rodrigo Duterte in changing your barangay, in securing your community, and in uplifting our entire Philippine Republic. Let me leave you with a quote from our national hero, Dr. Jose Rizal, 127 years ago. Where are the youth who will consecrate their golden hours, their illusions, and their enthusiasm for the betterment of our motherland? We await you, O youth. We await you. And until today and until tomorrow, the last day of filing, we will await for you. Come, for we await you. Thank you very much.
Okay, MPC questions? Mag-join ka sa SK? Rose? Microphone please. Rose Novenario Pataw.